Will everyone please rise for the bride? Be seated now, including you, grandmother. How is everyone doing on this fine, fine day? Very fine indeed. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Alex, and I've been tasked with this very, very important role of officiating this beautiful wedding today. And if you haven't figured it out yet, Ryan and I look pretty similar, except for the glasses, because, you know, we're brothers. Surprise! Me being the older one, of course, the more troublesome one than a guinea pig of my parents, I was always the first one to get clothes, to get new toys, to get new stuff. But today, Ryan beats me to the punch. He decides he wants to get married first, and, you know, we can keep on talking about how we competed all throughout our childhood, we beat each other up, but I'm pretty sure my mother is looking right at me right now, thinking that I'm going to say something really bad, so I'm going to block her out, and we'll instead talk about these two beautiful people and their love for one another on this day. So, from far across the great lands of California, New Jersey, China, we have some people from Thailand here. We gather here today to celebrate one of life's greatest gifts, the joining of two hearts, the joining of two lives. To all their guests, they are happy to share this moment with you. You watched them grow up, you went to school with them, you worked with them. One of them might just actually be your boss, and you're obligated to be here, or else, you know, come Monday. You are all the people that supported them and knew them so well. It is only right that you are the ones to share this once-in-a-lifetime moment with them today. And so we gather here today as the groom and bride present themselves to be married today, surrounded by the people they cherish most. We celebrate your love, for today, you two are getting married. And whereas no ceremony can create your marriage, what this ceremony can do is to witness and affirm the choice you make to stand together as partners and life mates. I feel like it was just yesterday that Ryan introduced me to Shelley. We were in Lake Tahoe, and I was to meet Shelley and her parents and her sister for the first time, you know, just casually meeting a whole family on the first visit, no big deal. But it didn't take much to realize that this was going to be pretty permanent, and that their relationship was pretty special. I tried to play it cool, because that's what brothers do, ignore each other. But Shelley was pretty hard to ignore. She was just so nice. Like, ridiculously nice. Too nice. She was considerate and gentle and way too accommodating for us. I don't know how she dealt with my brother, who is none of those things. And as the years went on, Shelley integrated herself into our family. She's been by Ryan's side ever since college, and today we're putting it on a legal binding paper that says Ryan and Shelley are to be married by all of you in Westlake Village on June 16th, 2018, with all the people that have traveled here from so far, and all made possible by the older brother that got his marriage officiant license online. Trust. You're welcome. So now I ask you to face one another and take each other's hands, which he's already doing. And I ask, Ryan, have you come here today with the intention to be legally joined in marriage? Do you pledge to choose respect, kindness, and compassion toward one another, to listen deeply to one another, and to speak to one another truthfully today and always?
I do!
And Shelley, have you come here today with the intention to be legally joined in marriage? Do you pledge to choose respect, kindness, and compassion toward one another, to listen deeply to one another, and to speak to one another truthfully today and always?
I do!
Yes. So now, Shelley and Ryan have chosen to write their own vows to one another, so I'll give them an opportunity to say them to one another here. Give me a second.
I'm up first. All right. All right, Shelley. How are you doing? Shelley, I love you so, so much. We've known each other for over 6 years now. That's pretty good. I told Shelley that I was gonna be emotionless. And I can without a doubt say that you changed my life. You changed me, the way I view the world, and you've made me a better person. Totally unemotional. You pushed me and challenged me to do more every single day, and you've supported me and my crazy ambitions, from quitting my job as a chemical engineer to starting Upkeep. And I honestly don't know where I'd be without you, and I try not to think about it because it's probably not nearly as happy of a story. So, today's the big day, and we're getting married. It means no more identifying me as a friend as your emergency contact. And a life full of challenges that we'll overcome together. Alright, so we're now supposed to do these vows. There's a lot that I can promise you, so here goes. For you guys that don't know, I wrote a poem for Shelley when we first started dating. I wrote a poem when I proposed. I only thought it would be appropriate to write a poem during our wedding. I promise to wake you up in the morning when you're too sleepy to get up, and to be by your side wherever we wind up. To continue squishing you at night as we're going to sleep, and to never rambling about Upkeep. To eat your leftovers and take your foe, and be better together and continue to grow. To love you, kiss you, and treat you well for the rest of my life. And to do everything in my power to make you the happiest wife. To take you on an adventure we'll never forget. And hopefully, do things we won't regret. To go places what we've never gone before. And to be the man you'll always adore. I promise to to always make you laugh and smile. For however long, even when I become senile. To respect your decision when we don't see eye to eye, and to stand by you and always be your guide. Shelley, the last 6 years have been the absolute best years of my life. We've had some amazing and crazy adventures, from Bakersfield to Asia. And frankly, it doesn't matter where we go as long as I'm with you. I absolutely love waking up by your side. Every single day reminds me that I'm marrying the perfect girl and the most perfect human being. You're wicked smart, insanely fun to be around, and overall, you make me the happiest person in the world. For that, I'm so thankful to you for allowing me into your heart and allowing and your entire family for allowing me into their home. I'm so excited to spend the rest of my life with you.
Dear Ryan Chan, founder and CEO of the best app in the world, you should all download it and write a 5-star review. I am so excited to be marrying you. The past 6 years have been the happiest of my life, filled with major life events, personal growth, and a lot of laughs. And volume. The type of Ryan Chan volume level that is inner ear damaging, caps lock always on, for the hard of hearing. According to my future mother-in-law, Catherine Chung, not surprisingly, Ryan wasn't great at doing his inside voice as a child. And neither was Alex. Must be genetic. To reminisce on a few of our awesome times together. Number one, late nights studying at the UC Berkeley Library where I fell asleep on my books and you blasted hardcore hip-hop while doing your engineering problem sets. Number two, moving in together to downtown Santa Barbara and enjoying weeknight walks along the beach. This is when I first learned that I will be finding a large amount of your dirty socks and clothes in random places for the rest of my life. Three, moving to your quote-unquote, mom's garage, which again is very misleading for those who've never seen it. It's nicer than it sounds. And lastly, four, seeing the unbelievable transformation of Upkeep from its first version, coded by you in our apartment in Westwood, to where it is today. And shout out to the awesome Upkeep crew out there. I was thinking about how to best characterize our relationship and couldn't help but think about food. I see us as a pot of little sheep hot pot, the yin yang shaped one with half spicy and half non-spicy soup on each side. You are like the spicy half of the soup pot. One that is sometimes so spicy, spontaneous, loud, adventurous, fun, passionate, and overflowing with flavor, that sometimes you have to take out the extra chili peppers. I love that you aren't afraid to take risks, to challenge yourself, to set your goals in the clouds and achieve them too. You're clear-minded, you know what you want, you'll find whatever way to get it, and you don't let what others think detract from your true passions. I, on the other hand, am the non-spicy soup. I'm still delicious, but safer choice. I love plants, I love organization, and I love the Container Store. I love Googling, researching, and asking for directions. This has definitely helped me get to where I am now, but I do think there's a lot of room for me to be better and a little spicier. So you, Ryan Chan, you challenge me to be okay with uncertainty, to not be afraid to pursue goals where there is a chance for failure. You help me shift my mentality to one that allows me to continue to grow. I promise to try to appreciate those mistakes and will turn them into scenic detours. I promise to stop and enjoy the moment before getting too anxious about what's coming next. So I thank you, my better half, for pushing me to become the soup with the perfect amount of spice. And even though we have our major differences, this is what I believe makes us stronger. And as we continue to grow together and push each other always to be better. After all, that's why they serve the two soups half and half, isn't it? I am so incredibly excited to be your wife. I promise to always stand by you and support you in all of your future dreams and whichever hurdles you will have to face. I am ready to commit to a lifetime of you, us, and pho beef noodle soup. Literally, pho ever.
Circle of love, so that wherever you go, you may always return to your shared life together. May these rings always call to mind the power of your love as you go about your day. May their circular form remind you that love, given freely, comes back around again and again. Ryan, take this ring and place it on Shelley's finger. Repeat after me. I, Ryan, take you, Shelley.
I, Ryan, take you, Shelley,
to be my wife.
To be my wife.
As a partner and companion.
To be a partner and companion.
Close enough.
To have and to hold.
To love and respect.
To love and respect.
To honor and to cherish.
To honor and to cherish.
Enjoy and in sorrow.
Enjoy and in sorrow.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
Now, Shelley, take this ring and place it on Ryan's finger. And repeat after me. I, Shelley, take you, Ryan.
I, Shelley, take you, Ryan.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
As a partner and companion.
As a partner and companion.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
To love and respect.
To love and respect.
To honor and to cherish.
To honor and to cherish.
Enjoy and in sorrow.
Enjoy and in sorrow.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
You know who's better at following directions. Ryan and Shelley have chosen each other, declared their love for one another and purpose before family and friends. You've made the pledge to love one another, symbolized by the giving and receiving of rings. So, by the virtue and authority invested in me by the state of California and the internet, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Our best wishes go forward to you from this day on, and we wish you a fulfilling life, rich in caring and in happiness. May you find a gentle and peaceful life that nurtures you and comforts you, and that reflects you honestly, kindness with honesty and kindness and integrity. There is a wonderful life ahead of you. Live it fully, and let it amaze you and bring you great joy. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor and privilege to present to you for the very first time Mr. Ryan Chan, CEO, and Dr. Shelley Shi, MD.